everyone, it's Els here at the Elizabeth Craft Design Studio. Today I'd like to show you the phone booth special kit from the Planner Essentials and the matching stamp set. So this is the kit. So what comes in the kit? So you basically get three full die sets. So you get the planner page, so the Planner Essentials page. You get the door, the numbers that go in the kind of the dial circle. This is a little label that you can put at the bottom here. Then on the back, you get a solid, so without the matching holes here, so it's not a page, but that can be kind of a layer on top of the other page, or it can be a slimline card as well. And then you get all the accessories. So you have the reinforcements from the phone, you get the handle here, you get a separate little phone with a circle. These are all the top pieces, and I'll show you that in a second. This is the power cord, which is super fun because you can kind of put it in all kind of different directions. And that's that circle, so those numbers, these ones, they can go in that circle. Then you get the hello here and another circle that kind of goes as a solid behind here. And this little piece goes in here. And then this little piece here, those are the hinges and the doorknob for the phone cell. So that is the phone booth itself. Then here we have the extra die that comes with the kit. So that's the page, a solid page, which also can be used in your planner, of course. And then an overlay, and then the speech bubbles, and the bookshelf, which is super cool because these are all separate books with a bookshelf. And then this says snapshots. So those are the dies that come in the set, in the kit. Then you get the rings to make your first book. See, if you want to make a small, like, book, you get the rings for that. And then you get an inspiration sheet. So this is the inspiration, so you see the pictures here, I'm going to show you those. And then here on the other side, you have more inspiration. And of course, you can find inspiration on our ECD, in our ECD planner and journaling group. So the matching stamp set is this one. So that comes separate. So that is the CS195 phone booth special stamps. So it has the true story, what's up, you have no idea how much I care about you, the telephone, it goes on the top of the booth, connected, flawsome, status update, the speech bubbles, and those speech bubbles, they match the speech bubbles that you see here. So that's super cool to combine. So that's a separate stamp set. So let me show you some samples. So first of all, of course, it is a planner page. So you can put it in your planner. You see, that's what you see here. Esther created this one, so she used her own paper here. Here you get one of the stamps. You see, so it is a planner page. But then, and then of course that extra die set, you can use that separate in your planner anywhere as well. So this is in my December day by day. So that is the planner page. And then I made some samples like making a mini book, slimline cards, a light for a candle. So let's start with the books and the slimline cards. I'm going to put these away, just going to go one at a time. So this one is what I did here. I had red cardstock and I painted that with an acrylic paint to give it a real look of the phone booth. So this is actually a wax seal that I had myself, so that's just kind of an extra. But a lot of people now, and I have a sample of that, put a little phone at the top as well. I don't know for sure if I have a sample. Did I? Oh yeah, I do. I do have a sample with that. And here I put one of the dies in from Esther. And here you see acetate, you see. And here I did that little label. I backed it here. So this has two sides of kind of the frame, which I think looks cool. So there's nothing in here yet. I'm just starting to build this one. So here you see that extra page with that overlay here, you see. So that's that one. And in this one you can write as well. I just used like an old paper I had. This is from the book, the Reminiscence, the book paper. And here you see all those extra things used. Washi tape here, the Reminiscence washi tape. It is such a cool set to work with. This is also from the book. Here I have a separate page again. Here I still need to work on something. Washi tape here, here and here. Because there's actually two rolls of the washi tape that fit perfect there. Here I have an extra, oh, I love this one. So this is from the book as well, the Reminiscence, the book. And then here I have an extra door because I made this one because I thought if I want to make an extra book, but I just put it in here for now. Here you see the phone booth reinforcement. Oh, and here you see also the hinges and the doorknob here. I cut it out of gold cardstock with tape on the back. And here I have some pages, you see. So all, and this is just the building of this. And here on the back, I did another one with the door. I need to add the hinges here. But now you have, you see, so that's the start of a book. Then I have other book samples here. So this is the one that Anita Isendoorn created. These are just a few pages. Normally this would go on a board for expo, but since we don't have shows, I just have them here now. That's why they have a white background. You see the reinforcements here. Look at those speech bubbles, the telephone stamp here. So you see the speech bubble dies and then stamped on there. And then the giraffe from Josette's line. I love that. And here you see that power cord that it can go all around. Here you see that same power cord, you see. And then the stamp, the layer here. So this is the extra page. I absolutely love that. That little phone here. And then here you see that circle, that dial circle. And here that's, you see, that's the solid, basically the solid circle that goes behind here. She used here, stamped on there. And look at the books here. I love how Anita did the books. So there's a bookshelf here. But of course you can also put that bookshelf in the front here as like when you normally entered a, like it was in the old days. But there was a shelf there with different phone books on there. So that's kind of the idea behind that. So you can also use it in the door, of course. Then this one, that's one Esther kind of designed for me. Instead of phone booth here, of telephone, she used North Pole here. So this can be a winter book, which is super cool. So she made a few pages here for me to start, because this is actually in our backyard here. So this can be your day by day for 2020 as well. Here the bookshelves here, that's James here at the fireplace, the snapshot here. Here you see the December die, that's also from Esther. And then here she used the paper, you see. So this is just the start of a book as well. There's some wood paper in here. I love this. This is something she must have had already, because you can use any paper in there, of course. So this is just the start of a book. Here's some old, this is all some old ephemera that Esther has. It's from 1920, you see. That's actually, that's 100 years ago. Oh, and that's a special one. So it says 31st of December, 1921. Wow, that is special. So that's 100 years old, what I have in there. That is amazing. I just noticed that for the first time, you see. So that's just a book. So you can add pictures to that. You can make it like a phone number book, like an address book. Correction, address book. So super, super cool set. It is really, really nice. Then I have here some cards I created. Just using that solid part that comes with the die set. And this is the size of a slimline card. So when I got this cut, I thought, let's see if it's a slimline card. And look at that. It is a perfect size for a slimline card. So what I did here, I did a cutout for the from the paper, the reminiscence paper. And then you make a score line on the back. So you cut it twice, make a score line on the back. And then you can just stand it up like this. And I think that's super cool. And in this one, I put the solid, that extra die here, so I can write a note on here, or a wish, or a birthday wishes. So how cool is that? Then this one, and I think this one is also in one of my Facebook lives. So I think you can find this back on social media, like on our YouTube channel. Same with this one. I also created this with a live. So here you see, I made the telephone here with one of those machines that you can use. Here is the phone, washi tape around here. This is Planner Essentials, love this so much. And all the paper I used here is from the Reminiscence, the book. And look at that, here, that number. So I gave the phone booth a number here instead of like just a label there. And then in here, I have the little monkey from Josette. And this is from the book, from the Reminiscence book as well. And I love this one. I love it. And again, you can just put it up like that, you see. And then the last card here, that is from Anita. And look at the detail that she did again. So she used the cutouts from the window here to make a kind of an extra layer here. The hello, the speech bubble. This is from the Planner Essentials. The little elf here from Josette. And the elf is standing on the hat that goes with the Frosty the Snowman. You see that phone cord here. Yeah, the detail on this one is just amazing. And Anita has a stand-up card as well. And what she has in here is a stamp from Sue Smith. From our house to yours. And I think that is a fantastic one for in a card. So that's that one. And then last but not least, so we have it in the planner. We have the mini books. We have the slimline cards. And then you can make a phone booth as a light. And I have a candle. And this is one of my Facebook Lives as well. So you can find this back on YouTube, how to make that. And you can put a battery-operated candle, not a real one, of course, because we're talking paper here. So you can put a battery-operated candle in there. Or you can put one of those string lights in there, those really tiny lights, and it gives a really nice effect as well. So what I did, I have one solid side and three open sides. And that's Planner Essentials. You recognize that. And then I have another one to show you. I'm going to put this flat. There you go. And then this one is another one. And I painted all this card. So this is all painted cardstock again. And when I was out of this red, I started to use another red. So acrylic paint. So here I use the dies from Suzanne Cannon. But look at that. How cool is that? So that is all I have to show you about the phone booth. But it is so much fun and endless possibilities. You know, there's a gravity phone booth we're talking about. So there's so much things you can do with it. So check it out. Check out our social media because you will find lots of inspiration there. And I want to thank you for watching. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you next time.